tarot, and this will be a collective reading. If you want a personal reading, feel free to see all my info below, including the deck I am using here called the Tarot Illuminati. I do have a link, or you can find it on your own. Now, the message that is coming out today is from a person that has walked away. This can be a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, seeing how Eight of Cups is, or the cup energy is the first energy. I also do have the Lovers at the bottom of the deck, which adds to this message because the message is coming from someone who walked away from a very special love connection, okay? They couldn't face it at the time. And also I see here that the feminine energy is very open and very secure and very sure about what is happening. But we do have a masculine energy now showing up as an emperor, someone who was more worried about financial security is what I get, because there is another four behind him, the Four of Pentacles, more worried about their kingdom, what they've built, than love. Okay, this king is also plated in gold and even has gold ab plates. So the person you're dealing with, I don't know, they're very rich is what I'm getting. The person that walked away, very rich. Okay, so let's see what's going on here. So put that there. And let's just put this up here. That's the energy of who this message is coming from. I want a card to actually fall out. That was the Two of Cups, okay? But it didn't come out. So we have the Star card and the World card. This is really interesting, being the next two cards to come out. It may actually be adding to the description of this person. This could be someone who had a lot of dreams and who easily obtain them, or at least, I don't know, with the gold plated energy, I mean, I think they easily obtain their dreams, or they have obtained them one way or another. This is someone who is quick. I'm getting like a quick turnover, so I don't know what that means for you personally, but there's something where, you know, one goal is achieved and they move on to the next, and they do this quite swiftly and quite successfully. You're really dealing with someone here who, with that gold-plated energy, is like Midas touch energy and also very successful in their achievements and endeavors, okay? Okay, let's get back to this now. So you're dealing with someone who is a goal achiever, and like I said, some sort of a quick turnover. Let's look into that more, what's going on with that. So now we have the Lovers coming out in reverse, and it's really interesting because, as I was saying, the quick turnover energy, I was looking at the World card and noticing that there is a naked female, but I mean, it's very realistic energy. And then next to her, I noticed we have another naked female in the Star energy. And when I say quick turnover, I almost feel that you could have been dealing with a player, for people that resonate with this, or someone who just tried to not be in love. Like, you know what I mean? They walked away from happiness because it involved love. And they went, wherever they went, maybe to achieve goals, to conquer the world, to be famous, and have their quick turnover of possibly of partners along the way. Okay, so let's see. And I do see the, you know, the Wheel of Fortune here. So this is someone who, you know, really does kind of move on quickly. And even above on the top of the Wheel of Fortune is another naked female. Okay, so let's see what else. So this person walked away. They possibly buried themselves in promiscuous behavior, to be honest, because it probably made them feel good with the Six of Wands. Like I said, this is someone who is seen by the public, okay? This is a public figure. I want to put that out there. And if you're like, oh, it's not a public figure, well, whether your person works for the police force, the fire station, the library, they are out in the public. They don't have to literally be famous, and they could be doing really good things in their community. So that can be the recognition energy I'm picking up here. But for some of you with the gold-plated emperor energy, you're really dealing with a highly successful, powerful person who is seen by the public. And the reason it was easy for them to go, to leave their true happiness, to go off, is because, you know, that seems to be part of their lifestyle. There's many people, there's many entertainment situations here. There's just a lot going on all different levels, okay? So let's see what else we get here. So what does this person want to say? This person wants to say that they want to come back to you. They realize the connection, because I'm seeing this, because we have the Six of Cups and the Nine of Pentacles is here at the bottom. But this person is clearly not feeling good about what they've done, right? So when I ask for the energy of the person that we're picking up on and what they want to say, well, okay, this person has walked away from a situation, but they don't look happy. They actually, even though the public may see them as strong and courageous and brave and awesome energy, creative even, powerful energy, but really that's just a front. So this person wants to say that they have been thinking about the past. They're literally watching you. They're watching you grow for many of you, or they've watched you grow now. They see that you're happy. This person is literally remembering the past, and that's a very heavy energy here, okay? They're literally remembering the innocent days of love and of what they desire with you, possibly how they feel with you. If this person is thinking about you in the past, some of you may know this person from childhood, okay? So let's see what else has just come out. I'm going to start with the top. We do have the King of Pentacles, and underneath the King of Pentacles is the Queen of Cups. And I feel like this person is actually reminiscing about what they wish they had done, okay? Because underneath that was the Four of Cups. I feel like you had offered this person your love with the Queen of Cups energy, and they didn't take it. And I feel that they're reminiscing about what they would like to do or would have liked to do in the past, which was give you a cup. But this person didn't take it. And the reason they didn't take it is because this person was stuck in the energy of the Playboy, of the King of Wands energy, and of, you know, showing off, showering. I am getting a lot of strip club energy here. So making it rain at the strip clubs. And, you know, I'm not dissing anyone, not at all, just so you know. I'm just saying that's what this person, it looks like they were doing. Having fun, a lot of fun, okay? So am I ready here? I do see the way this spilled out. I'm not sure if you can see it, but the Chariot is at the bottom. So that is part of this message. And the two cards showing their face are the Prince of Cups and the Eight of Pentacles. So let me see, because underneath the Prince of Cups, we have the Seven of Pentacles. This person wants you to know that they have never, you know this person. I feel like you know this person, but maybe they've been gone for quite some time, okay? You may know them from childhood, or you may have known them for a long time, right? But regardless, you have an extremely spiritual, memorable connection with this person. And there's something where this person hasn't forgotten you with the Prince of Cups and the Seven of Pentacles behind it. They want to come back to that. Like you're still a part of their energy. With the Eight of Pentacles, they want to do it right this time around. I am going to clarify the Eight of Pentacles specifically. But with the Chariot, this person really, there's something here where this person wants to actually show you and make an effort for you, whoever resonates with this message. And they're willing almost to take off that image, to take off that gold energy. Look at an ending to the old ways, to the nonsense that they were involved in. I'm getting so much like like the tents and the parties and all of this type of energy that this person was dealing with. Sorry, the 444 alarm was going off. I'm not sure when or why I set that. Anyhow, it feels good to see that number. But yes, so this person is done with the death card and the seven of swords of playing games. And look at what comes after there's an ending to that. The four of wands. This is this person coming forward to you to let you know that. And another message I get with the Eight of Pentacles specifically. Oh, wow. Interesting. So I'm going to say what the message is that I was getting first before I get into that. This person is taking off that gold shield, you know, that gold armor and melting it down there. This person wants to work on things with you and also work on being natural, being humble, being accepting, not being afraid, being vulnerable, right? So we just had two queens come out, and I'm going to clarify what this is about first and then into, okay. So the Two of Wands is underneath that and the Ace of Wands. So there definitely has been a decision made here, but now I'm going to clarify what the Queen of Wands represents. We have another queen here. So let me show you how this came out. So the Queen of Wands is representing you. And if you want to know where I get that information from, it's the way my cards are talking to me right now. We do have the Nine of Pentacles with the Queen of Pentacles, okay? And earlier you came up as the Queen of Pentacles energy. So this person has this choice between you. And then we have this Queen of Swords, and I'm going to clarify that as well. Queen of Swords energy, please. So interesting. We have the Five of Cups clarifying the Queen of Swords. So this is the female energy that, you know, does get left. And with the Five of Cups, let's put this over here. With the Five of Cups and the King of Cups underneath, okay, I really feel that this is saying this was a very hard decision for your person. You know, they had a lot of regrets about how they handled the Queen of Swords, the person they left. I'm not quite sure why, but I do feel that this is a very loving person. I'm seeing the Hangman stick out if you want to see what I'm talking about there. But this person hung on. And I feel like this person hung on for a long time, even to the demise of themselves or to the downfall of their own health, possibly mental, maybe, right? With the King of Cups energy here, this person could hang on no longer, okay? Because I'm seeing Nine of Wands energy here, and I'm seeing even an Ace of Wands here. So it was time for a completion to that cycle. That is really interesting that those came out. Let's look into the Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Fire energy here. So that's for the viewer energy here. And this is very powerful. Very powerful. Okay, I was about to ask more questions here. But we have the Ten of Wands. So that's been a struggling path. And almost an unexpected, unknowing path, okay? I feel that you, the viewer, in regards to this person, it was a journey. It was a difficult one, and one that you had to have faith in, with the Wheel of Fortune being clarified by the Fool card and how these cards are showing themselves, the Chariot and the Hangman. I feel, you know, you had to have faith in this situation that it would return, that your loves were loyal to each other, and that this person that was once stuck in a situation would leave and come forward. Like, that's beautiful, beautiful energy there. So that's talking a little about you. And one more for the Queen of Swords energy here, the person that has been left according to the cards, or will be left eventually, soon possibly. So we have the Five of Wands, and that card's there too. and the Ten of Cups and the Five of Pentacles. So this was fighting in the home energy. Okay, I take it both parties were unhappy. Okay, just a lot of argument. I'm hearing like tolerance, but then non-tolerance. So someone could not tolerate something anymore. With the Ten of Cups, this was possibly a family situation or a long-term connection. And it's interesting because I am seeing, that just fell, the Ace of Cups. Oh, that's weird. But that tells me that there was, no, I'm not, well, I'm not getting it. I'm actually getting that this, there wasn't, it was not a healthy love. And then when I looked at the picture, look at the hand in the picture. It's warped and deformed. So remember I said this was affecting this person's health. It really was. And sometimes we have health defects that happen that we don't really realize are from a situation. Like let's just say, for example, someone's arm starts getting stiffer or moving less. That's a sign that there's something else going on within your system of life, right? Like, I mean, of course, I'm not a doctor, and of course there could be actual issues, but there are hardenings of body parts that happen. Even the heart can get encapsulated with calcium or whatever it may be, fat even, you know, from whatever it is, but it's a representation usually of turmoil going on inside of a person. You know, it does express itself physically. So this person was trying to hold on to the very last second of this connection, okay? And that's over here with the Queen of Swords, but it is over. And I do have a message for anyone that's concerned about the person that's being left. This person will actually be meeting a beautiful love energy, or it just looks like they're either going back to or communicating and meeting someone that they truly are passionate about. Look at that, the Judgment card. So with the ending of this partnership, yes, that Queen of Swords energy is either returning to a past love or having a new awakening or having a new beginning in a relationship with someone else, and they will have a fulfilling relationship. That's interesting. Let's get one more card for your person. So that was that last message there was about the Queen of Swords energy, the one being left. They're going to be happy, okay? And what do we have for your person? Didn't flip over. So this is the Ace of Wands I'm seeing here, but we have the Six of Swords, and I just feel like there's a relevance to that. This is about a new beginning. I know the Six of Swords is about someone coming out of it is a transformation. Wow. Wow, that's beautiful. The Ace, another Ace here. The Six of Swords is someone who almost has gone through the dark night of the soul. And that's interesting. When I say that, I open the deck to the sun. So this person is getting an opportunity at a fresh start. And I feel it's, in general, a fresh start in life. We'll see. Can we get any more with your connection with this person? And this fresh start, anything here? Come out. I don't know what it was. Oh my gosh, we have, oh, we're back here. So the message is completed, but we do have the Two of Swords and the Ace of Swords. So this fresh start truly is about making just the decision to go for exactly what this person wants. This person is coming in, this Emperor is coming in, and if you had any confusion, you are about to get communication. Or I don't know if you're about to. I will pull a time card because I said that, but you will be getting communication, truth, clarity, and a new opportunity. Do we have a time energy for this? Let's see. And we have Justice with the High Priestess. So I do feel that that's an energy of when it's time, kind of having patience, knowing that this will happen exactly at the right time. That is Libra energy. And the High Priestess, I just know it's Piscean, I believe, or Moony energy, right? I'm going to pull a couple cards from the Love deck because I'm really guided to, and we will see what's coming out. If you like these type of messages, please let me know. So when you pass from this world, you take nothing with you but your soul and the memories you have shared with those you love. And that may be what that person was reminiscing about with the Six of Cups energy. Like they don't want to leave this world without spending time with you. So transformation, this was all part of a huge transformation. Your relationship with one another is about to deepen. Love conquers and transforms all things. Freedom is at the bottom of that. This is the year of the free one. That's what I found in my research on 2021. MMXXI, 21st year of the third millennium. Okay, let's see what else is coming out here. One more card, reflect. Give each other some space at the moment. Trust and have faith that all will work out for the best. And we got that message, right, with the Fool energy, I believe. It was saying that you had to learn to have trust and faith in this situation. Okay, so thank you so much. I really hope that you enjoy this. If so, let me know in the comments. And I'd really appreciate thumbs up because it helps the channel. Bye for now.